Good morning, all. We are concluding our reading of 2 Chronicles. Today's chapters 34 to 36. We read of some of these events in 2 Kings chapters 24 to 25. In this account, we get some more information and better overall picture of the history. A prophecy of Jeremiah, Daniel chapters 9 verse 2, Lamentations and Nehemiah chapters 1 and 2 are subsequent events directly connected to the following chapters. Now, I did chapters 34 verse 1 to 7 yesterday, so I will start at verse 8. We are still on Josiah reigns in Judah, and we are now coming on to the book of the law is found.
Now in the 18th year of his reign, when he had purged the land and the house, he sent Shaphan the son of Azaliah, and Maaseiah the governor of the city, and Joah the son of Joahaz the recorder, to repair the house of the Lord his God. When they came to Hilkiah the high priest, they delivered the money that was brought into the house of God, which the Levites that kept the doors had gathered of the hand of Manasseh and Ephraim, and of all the remnant of Israel, and of all Judah and Benjamin, and they returned to Jerusalem.
Jump into verse 14.
They brought out the money that was brought into the house of the Lord. Hilkiah the priest found the book of the law of the Lord given by Moses. And Hilkiah answered and said to Shaphan the scribe, I have found the book of the law in the house of the Lord. And Hilkiah delivered the book to Shaphan. And Shaphan carried the book to the king and brought the king word back again, saying, all that was committed to thy servants, they do it. And they have gathered together the money that was found in the house of the Lord, and have delivered it into the hand of the overseers, and to the hand of the workmen. Then Shaphan the scribe told the king, saying, Hilkiah the priest hath given me a book. And Shaphan read it before the king. And it came to pass, when the king had heard the words of the law, that he rent his clothes. And the king commanded Hilkiah and Ahikam, the son of Shaphan, and Abdon, the son of Micah, and Shaphan, the scribe, and Azariah, the servant of the king, saying, go inquire of the Lord for me, and for them that are left in Israel and in Judah, concerning the words of the book that is found. For great is the wrath of the Lord that is poured out upon us, because our fathers have not kept the word of the Lord, to do after all that is written in this book. And Hilkiah and they that the king had appointed went to Huldah the prophetess, the wife of Shallum, the son of Tikvah, the son of Hazra, keeper of the wardrobe. Now she dwelt in Jerusalem in the college, and they spake to her to that effect. And she answered them, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, tell ye the man that sent you to me, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring evil upon this place, and upon the inhabitants thereof, even all the curses that are written in the book which they have read before the king of Judah. Because they have forsaken me, and have burned incense unto other gods, that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands. Therefore my wrath shall be poured out upon this place, and shall not be quenched. And as for the king of Judah, who sent you to inquire of the Lord, so shall ye say unto him, thus saith the Lord God of Israel concerning the words which thou hast heard. Because thine heart was tender, and thou didst humble thyself before God, when thou heardest his words against this place, and against the inhabitants thereof, and humbledst thyself before me, and didst rend thy clothes, and weep before me, I have even heard thee also, saith the Lord. Behold, I will gather thee to thy fathers, and thou shalt be gathered to thy grave in peace. Neither shall thine eyes see all the evil that I will bring upon this place, and upon the inhabitants of the same. So they brought the king word again. Then the king sent, and gathered together all the elders of Judah and Jerusalem. And the king went up into the house of the Lord, and all the men of Judah, and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and the priests, and the Levites, and all the people, great and small. And he read in their ears all the words of the book of the covenant that was found in the house of the Lord. And the king stood in his place and made a covenant before the Lord, to walk after the Lord, and to keep his commandments, and his testimonies, and his statutes, with all his heart, and with all his soul, to perform the words of the covenant which are written in this book.
Moving on to chapter 35.
Chapter 35. Moreover, Josiah kept a Passover unto the Lord in Jerusalem, and they killed the Passover on the 14th day of the first month. And he set the priests in their charges, and encouraged them to the service of the house of the Lord.
Continuing from verse 17, after they have concluded the Passover.
And the children of Israel that were present kept the Passover at that time, and the Feast of Unleavened Bread 7 days.
Continuing from verse 20.
After all this, when Josiah had prepared the temple, Necho, king of Egypt, came up to fight against Carchemish by Euphrates, and Josiah went out against him. But he sent ambassadors to him, saying, What have I to do with thee, thou king of Judah? I come not against thee this day, but against the house wherewith I have war. For God commanded me to make haste, forbear thee from meddling with God, who is with me, that he destroy thee not. Nevertheless, Josiah would not turn his face from him, but disguised himself that he might fight with him, and hearkened not unto the words of Necho from the mouth of God, and came to fight in the valley of Megiddo. And the archers shot at King Josiah, and the king said to his servants, Have me away, for I am sore wounded. His servants therefore took him out of that chariot and put him in the second chariot that he had. And they brought him to Jerusalem, and he died, and was buried in one of the sepulchres of his fathers. And all Judah and Jerusalem mourned for Josiah, and Jeremiah lamented for Josiah, and all the singing men and the singing women spake of Josiah in their lamentations to this day, and made them an ordinance in Israel, and behold, they are written in the lamentations. Now the rest of the acts of Josiah, and his goodness according to that which was written in the law of the Lord, and his deeds first and last, behold, they are written in the book of the kings of Israel and Judah.
Chapter 36.
Then the people of the land took Jehoahaz, the son of Josiah, and made him king in his father's stead in Jerusalem. Jehoahaz was 23 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 3 months in Jerusalem. And the king of Egypt put him down at Jerusalem and condemned the land in 100 talents of silver and 1 talent of gold. And the king of Egypt made Eliakim his brother king over Judah at Jerusalem, and turned his name to Jehoiakim. And Necho took Jehoahaz his brother and carried him to Egypt. Jehoiakim was 25 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 11 years in Jerusalem, and he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord his God. Against him came up Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and bound him in fetters to carry him to Babylon.
Note another name change by a pagan king, as they would do with Daniel and his colleagues. Continuing from verse 13. Zedekiah is made a ruler, or should I say king, under the rulership of Babylon.
And he also rebelled against King Nebuchadnezzar, who had made him swear by God. But he stiffened his neck and hardened his heart from turning unto the Lord God of Israel. Moreover, all the chief of the priests and the people transgressed very much after all the abominations of the heathen, and polluted the house of the Lord which he had hallowed in Jerusalem. And the Lord God of their father sent to them by his messengers, rising up betimes and sending, because he had compassion on his people and on his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God, and despised his words, and misused his prophets, until the wrath of the Lord arose against his people, till there was no remedy. Therefore he brought upon them the king of the Chaldees, who slew their young men with a sword in the house of their sanctuary, and had no compassion upon young man or maiden, old man, or him that stooped for age. He gave them all into his hand. And all the vessels of the house of God, great and small, and the treasures of the house of the Lord, and the treasures of the king, and of his princes, all these he brought to Babylon. And they burnt the house of God, and brake down the wall of Jerusalem, and burnt all the palaces thereof with fire, and destroyed all the goodly vessels thereof. And them that had escaped from the sword carried he away to Babylon, where they were servants to him and his sons, until the reign of the kingdom of Persia, to fulfill the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah, until the land had enjoyed her Sabbath. For as long as she lay desolate, she kept Sabbath to fulfill 70 years. Now in the first year of Cyrus king of Persia, that the word of the Lord spoken by the mouth of Jeremiah might be accomplished, the Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus king of Persia, that he made a proclamation throughout all his kingdom, and put it also in writing, saying, Thus saith Cyrus king of Persia, All the kingdoms of the earth hath the Lord God of heaven given me, and he hath charged me to build him an house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Who is there among you of all his people? The Lord his God be with him, and let him go up.
So, some verses to note. God chose to speak through a pagan king, as he had done previously with regard to Abimelech and Abraham, Genesis chapters 12, verses 17 to 20 and 23 to 7. We see the importance of the keeping the Sabbath, because they did not let the land keep the Sabbath. God has done what he did. That is in verse 21. Verse 19, they see the damage that they did, and that will be important for when the commandments given to Nehemiah to go and undo what was done, or to build back what was broken down. And we also see the 70 years is mentioned. So what have we got so far? The tribes of Israel were scattered by the Syrians into Gentile, meaning foreign nations, with no specific given time period when they will return, except for it being dependent on the Messiah's coming. Judah, as predicted by Jeremiah, were taken to Babylon with a predicted return time of 70 years. Daniel understood this prophecy and prayed the prayer of repentance on behalf of Judah. Then, later, at the end of the 70 years, Nehemiah and Ezra led the return back to the land to rebuild the wall and the city which the Babylonians destroyed, as I said in verse 36:19 above. Also prophesied in Daniel 9:25 would be when the Messiah would come the first time, i.e. for the time of Nehemiah, from the time Nehemiah receives the permission from King Cyrus to return and rebuild Jerusalem. If we then look back into time, into Jewish history, not Christian history as some do, we see the predictions of Daniel were fulfilled to the exact time periods prophesied. This was through the book of the Maccabees and so forth, Jewish history. So considering God, through the book of Jeremiah and Daniel, foretold of future events that our human history now confirms, we can be assured of the writings in the Bible compared to any other religious book or belief. Thus, which God and faith to follow as the true God? Shalom, until tomorrow, God willing.